Hello everyone, I am Robin Mesnage, lead data scientist at the Buchinger Wilhelmi Clinics, and today I will share with you an exciting topic about fasting and the brain. The brain is a fascinating organ. This is basically the seat of your consciousness, who you are, and this is also a very demanding organ. Approximately 20% of your energy you eat during the day is going for your brain. So you can wonder what happens if you are stopping eating during the fast in the brain to your energy levels. This is a good opportunity to clear a misconception. When you stop eating and start a fast, your energy levels in your brain will not decrease. You flip the metabolic switch and you start burning your fat. This has very important consequences for your brain, because switching from carbs to fat is like switching to a clean energy for your brain, because burning fat will cause much less damage to your cells than burning carbs. What I mean by damage is oxidative stress, this toxic process which can damage your cells, damage your tissue, makes your brain age or promote some disease. So it's like an anti-aging mechanism. When you start fasting, you will also activate a process called autophagy. This is like a recycling process. You will take your old cells, break them down, and create new ones. So this is another anti-aging process which is activated in your brain when you start a fast. Now you can wonder, with all these changes, what happens to your mood or your behavior during fasting? Everyone is different, and so people will have different reactions to the fast, but some changes are quite common. When you start a fast, after one day or two, when you switch your metabolism to fat burning, you will feel generally better, lightheaded. Some people even feel that they are euphoric. This is a part that I quite liked when I fasted. And this is because the ketone bodies, which are the molecules produced by fat burning, they can have a stimulatory effect on your brain and they act like hormones. After a few days, when your fasting metabolism is well established, and you burn fat efficiently, you generally feel fully energized, and it's like if your brain is less foggy, you feel more sharp. And we understand what happens in the brain at the molecular level, leading to these important changes. When you start fasting, you activate a rejuvenation process. You start producing a molecule called BDNF. This is for brain-derived neurotrophic factor. And this is a molecule which will lead to the creation of new neurons, helping making more connections between the neurons. And this molecule is produced super quickly. Some studies show that after 48 hours of fasting, the levels of this BDNF are increasing by 350%. And many medical studies show the importance of this molecule for health, because lower levels of BDNF in human population, this is linked to smaller brain volumes, while high level of BDNF, this is generally linked to improved cognition. And this is why we can see that fasting has many effects on your mood and on cognition. And this is also sometimes considered as a way we can treat neurodegenerative disease. We mostly have proof in animal models, so very little clinical trials have been done, but this is a very interesting way for research to move forward. When you are fasting, many other hormonal changes happen in your brain. Serotonin, you might have heard of that one. This is a hormone which is linked to appetite, cognition, better mood, and this hormone is increasing during fasting. Adrenaline. Adrenaline is also going up during fasting, and we can understand why. And this is also explaining how the behavior is changing during fasting. Because we need to understand that this, when adrenaline is going up during fasting, this is because it's activating our prehistoric brain. And we can understand that our ancestors, when food was missing, they needed to be fully energized to find some food. And this is why evolution has made us very tolerant to fasting, and we are feeling fully energized during fasting. You can also understand that if our ancestors were feeling sleepy during fasting, they could have less chance of surviving. So this is why our brain is producing all these hormones when you start feeling fasting, and this is why you are feeling fully energized and also feeling better. So now, on to a big question. Can fasting affect cognition? Many studies are claiming that fasting can improve memory, improve cognition, and there's actually a lot of scientific studies which have been done. These studies have been done mostly in animals, and these studies show that fasting can improve memory, improve cognition, and also even decrease the severity of strokes. These studies were done in animal models, so we need more clinical trial, and they should be taken with a pinch of salt. It doesn't mean that they are bad studies, but at the moment, we need more science to understand the effect of fasting on cognition. So let's summarize what the science is saying about fasting and the brain. So first, fasting is activating anti-aging process in your brain via the production of BDNF, decreased oxidative stress. Then fasting is increasing your mood, decreasing stress levels. This is what we have shown at the Buchinger Wilhelmi Clinics. Patients are reporting feeling better and having less stress level. Fasting can also have some pain-relieving effects. I didn't mention that, but a few clinical trials show that when you fast, you have less inflammation, and so it can be much better for neuroinflammatory disorders, so disease where you have pains in your pain in your nerves. This is a promising therapeutic way for that, but we need more clinical studies. Same for the prevention of neurodegenerative disease like Alzheimer and Parkinson. In animal models, fasting has amazing effect, but we need more studies also in humans. Fasting can improve cognition. This is shown also in a few studies, and also we need more science. So altogether, you can see that fasting has good effect in the brain, anti-aging effect, making you feel better. We can almost say antidepressant. And for other topics like cognition and memory, we need more studies. And this is also why actually our research program at the Buchinger Wilhelmi Clinics is super important. We are doing studies at the moment on fasting and sleep, fasting and well-being, and we see amazing effect, but we still need more science for understanding the whole picture of effects of fasting on brain. Thank you for watching the video. And if you want to know more about fasting and the brain or other topics, please follow our channels. Hope to see you soon. Bye. Thank you.